everyone, and welcome. My name is Mandie Curtis Banks, and I am the Programs and Events Assistant here at the Scott Arboretum, and I'm representing hashtag BranchOut, our digital learning series, where we share information for every gardening enthusiast. So I'm here today to do a nature-based lesson and an art activity that's perfect for children of all ages and for families to share together. So today we are going to talk about pollinators. And I actually have a very special friend that I'd like to bring out to help me. So, come on out. He's a little shy. Come on, it's okay. They're really friendly, I promise. Hey, Buzz, how are you? What are you up to today?
Well, I was just buzzing around your yard today and was enjoying hanging out on those beautiful bright red flowers in your front yard.
Oh yeah, those are my echinacea flowers. Some people know them as cone flowers.
Oh, I really like those. They're so bright and cheery and sweet.
Yeah, those are some of my favorite flowers too, Buzz. So Buzz, did you know that you perform a very special job at visiting flowers like echinacea? You are a pollinator. Do you know what that means?
Well, I know us honeybees love to visit flowers with colorful petals and lovely scents. And sometimes when I visit a beautiful flower, I get a sweet, sugary treat.
Yes, that's called nectar.
Oh yeah, I love that stuff. Ooh, delicious. And then when I'm hanging out on the flower, lots of times fluffy orange stuff sticks to me. And I think when I visit other flowers, that sticky orange stuff lands on those flowers.
Yeah, that's right, Buzz. That sticky stuff is called pollen. And when you bring pollen from one flower to another, you are helping the pollination process, which is how flowers grow.
Well, I feel pretty special. I'll keep doing my pollinator duty if you keep planting those beautiful flowers I like to visit.
Of course. I love having pollinator plants in my garden, too. Maybe you guys have some pollinator plants at home in your garden. So, Buzz, did you know that there are other animals that are pollinators as well?
Well, I saw my friend the other day, Mary Posa, the butterfly. Yeah, she was buzzing around that really tall pink plant with the small little pink flowers.
That's called phlox. That's another great pollinator plant. And yes, you are right. Butterflies are also excellent pollinators. I think Mariposa is a monarch butterfly.
Oh yeah, she's a beauty.
So some other examples of pollinators are birds. Like hummingbirds.
Oh, I love hummingbirds. Their wings go really, really, really fast.
I love them too. They're really neat. And some insects like ants, flies, and beetles.
Oh yeah, I've seen those guys hanging around.
And bats.
What? Bats? Wow, so cool.
Yeah, that is pretty cool, Buzz. I agree. So, Buzz, you are so cute. I think I would like to show my friends at home how to make one. Make it little buzz bee just like you. How does that sound?
Well, that would be fantastic!
Yeah, I think it'll be fun too. So, Buzz, I would like a little bit of help though. So, I'm going to bring my daughter Sophie over to give us some help. Sophie, come on over.
I love Sophie! Oh, can I give you a little bee smooch?
Sure, Buzz. Well, Buzz, you are certainly a honeybee.
Oh, you are so sweet. Okay, well, I'm just going to buzz on over here while Mandie and Sophie show you how to make a little bee like me.
All right, thank you so much, Sophie. All right, so we're ready to talk you through how you're going to make a little pollinator bee like Buzz. I'm going to scoot him this way so you can see him. And so the main part of our pollinator bee is made out of a... Ta-da! Toilet paper roll! Great way to reuse something. So I'm sure you all have toilet paper at home. So we're going to use a toilet paper roll. We need some construction paper. We want to use bee colors. So we have yellow, black, and we have some white for the wings as well. We also are going to need, if you have a black pipe cleaner, that's really fun for the antennae. Can you show us our black pipe cleaner, Sophie? We have some googly eyes, which are really fun to use. You probably can't see them. They're so teeny, teeny, tiny.
Oh, I'll show them mine up close, see?
So if you have some googly eyes, great. If you don't, go ahead and just draw your own eyes right on there. We also have using a black marker to draw the face. We have a Sharpie here. We want to have some glue or a glue stick. I found good old Elmer's glue works really, really well. We want to, if you have some double stick tape, that works great for the wings. And again, if you don't have that, no worries. You can use regular old scotch tape or some glue as well. We want to have some scissors to cut those out, all the construction pieces out. We want to have a ruler to measure out all our paper bits and a nice pencil to do some tracing. All right, so we're going to start with Buzz's body, although maybe you're going to call your bee something else. So we're going to start with... We're gonna start with our toilet paper roll. Roll that toilet paper roll on there. So we're gonna line it up at the bottom and over to the side. Okay, she's gonna get ready to trace. And what you wanna do is hold on tight as we roll here. And when one end of the paper touches, that should be just enough. So Sophie's gonna trace right where that paper joins there. Not too far in, Soph, because we wanna have that a little bit further. It doesn't have to be perfectly straight. You can cut it straighter.
Yeah.
You want to find the edge of that tube. So I just press in here where I find that indentation. I'm going to make a little mark there. And then Sophie, if you would go ahead and measure. So we're going to go from the end of the paper to that line, a nice straight line. And you're just going to trace along there.
Okay.
Yeah. Perfect. So now if you would cut that rectangle out. And then
here?
Yeah. And after she cuts it out, she's just going to go ahead and glue that paper right onto our toilet paper tube. So while she's doing that, I'm going to talk through the stripes for our bee. So you're going to need some black paper. You don't need very much. I have just a little bit here. You're going to take your ruler and you're going to grab some white chalk because a pencil or a pen can be very hard to see on black paper. So we thought about 6 inches in length is perfect. So go ahead and get your ruler, draw a nice straight line of 6 inches across with your chalk. And then about a half inch wide is all you need. You don't need very wide stripes here because we want to have a couple of them on our bee. So I would do that on either end, measure in a half inch from the end, and then go ahead and connect those two. And there you have a nice bee, a nice bee stripe. So you would do that 3 times in total so that you have 3 separate strips to put on your bee. So I went ahead and pre-cut some strips for us. The yellow paper cut, she's gonna take the glue and she's just gonna put it right on that construction paper.
Okay.
I'll hold it down for you. So you don't need a ton, just a little nice squiggle back and forth. I'm going to put a little bit more on there, okay? The whole thing, because you want it to really stick. She focused in on the ends, which was smart.
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to line it up. I'm going to get the glue out of the way so you can see. She's lining it up there, and she's just going to wrap that paper on top.
Yeah, I'm just going to line this up.
All right, so now we have the body. Give it a couple sticks. Maybe just press it real evenly all around. All right, I'm giving it a good press down there. All right, so now we're going to take each of our strips and you're going to do just a little bit of glue on each of those.
Okay.
So while Sophie works on those, so basically you want to space them out so that you see yellow in between. So it's your choice how you want to do
like
that.
Layers.
Okay. So I'm going to do the next one. So if you can sort of line up the ends on the same side, that's good. So as she finishes up the stripes, I am going to go ahead and talk about the wings.
Okay.
So basically, we want to have 2 little circle wings. You can see them on our bee here. And we found the easiest way to do this is to actually just take the toilet paper roll itself, and you're going to put it on the paper, and you're actually going to trace it around. So I'm going to go ahead and do this, Sophie, just so we can save time.
Okay.
So you're going to take your pencil, you've got it on the paper, and you're just going to trace around so you have a nice circle. I don't know if you can see that. And I'm going to do second one there. And it doesn't matter if it's perfectly even. We are going to take those wings and we're going to put them right on the body. So you want to have them about 3/4 of the way up. So if you can put a one on each side, so what I did is put some sticky tape on, And Sophie's just going to put that right end there. And you can see the wings around the front. Excellent. All right. So let's talk antennas. So I took a nice long black pipe cleaner, and I used my scissors, and I just cut it in half, because you don't need the whole thing. I take some of that tape. Oh, first, yes, that's right. We want to do some curly edges on our pipe cleaner. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to put that right on the inside. So you want to do the front part of your bee. That's where you're going to tape it. You can see on
inside,
my bows here.
The front.
On the inside, yes. All right, so if you line it up there, I'll stick the tape in. So, do we have everything?
Nope.
What are we missing?
A face.
A face, of course. So you're going to take your black marker. You're going to put a cute little smile on there. Sophie, why don't you do that? Mm-hmm. I'm going to do the googly eyes here. So I'm just putting a little drop of glue on each googly eye. She's got a great smile on there. I'm going to pop the googly eyes on. We did it!
Mm-hmm. Buzz, look!
Oh, hello. What's your name?
I'm Beatrice.
Beatrice, what a lovely name!
I love it. Buzz and Beatrice, a perfect pollinator pair. So we are at the end of our lesson today. Thank you so much for joining us. I hope that you enjoyed learning about pollinators and making some bees with us. I hope you come up with a really fun, creative honeybee name as well. So if you've enjoyed this video, you may want to go and check out our Scott Arboretum website. Mm-hmm. So if you click on the Scott at Home link, you will find some other hashtag BranchOut videos. There's lots of family videos on there of activities we've done. I also wanted to mention, if you've enjoyed these videos, I hope you will consider joining us. This fall, I'm going to be teaching a weekly family program that's going to be starting the first week in October, and it's going to be Wednesday mornings at 10 a.m. and it's going to be virtual, so all you need to do is upload or download Zoom, and you do need to pre-register. So in a little bit we will have our fall programs up on our Scott Arboretum page under events. So I do hope you check that out and consider joining us. It's for pre-K students and their caregivers, and it should be a lot of fun. So we're at the end here.
Yes.
Come on, Buzz, let's go and dance on some food.
Oh, I would love to dance. I really do like that. Hey, I wanted to ask you, who's your favorite singer?
Well, Beyonce, of course. How about you?
Oh, Beyonce's great, but I like the Bee Gees. Should we do some dancing?
Yeah.
All right.